You can enter the queue editor by clicking the Edit button on the queue, by right-clicking anywhere on the queue and selecting Edit Queue, or by going to the Edit menu and selecting Edit Queue. Once you are in the queue editor, you can select areas of the queue to edit by choosing the appropriate tab and using the tools and settings provided. The General tab provides access to basic settings that are frequently altered, like the transition into a queue, the advance out of a queue, the queue notes, etc. These settings can be changed for a single page, or they can be applied to the entire queue. The Main Object tab may contain several types of content. Text that flows across multiple pages, including song lyrics or Bible passages, web pages, PowerPoint presentations, or PDF files. On this tab, you can edit and adjust the formatting of text objects or change objects. There can only be one main object in a queue, and the settings that are shown will vary depending on the type of object that is used. The Other Objects tab is where you can insert and manage content that does not flow from page to page. This includes image files, video clips, and text boxes. You can add a virtually unlimited number of other objects, format them, and even apply the object and formatting to all pages in a queue if desired. The lower left corner of this tab displays a list of all the objects that are in use. The Stage Display tab allows you to customize the content shown on the stage display. You can select between showing the text from the main object, customized text, and showing the same content as the main display. The Sounds tab allows you to apply a sound file to the queue so that it plays when you fire the queue or one of its pages. The Info tab is your window into the behind-the-scenes information. This is where you can edit lyric library data fields, assign a song to a lyric group, or add a cue to the announcement library. To insert text that flows from page to page or is paginated, like song lyrics, Bible passages, extensive sermon notes, or readings, you can use the Main Object tab. Text on this tab can use page breaks and behaves much like a typical word processor. When you create a lyric or Bible cue, the text of those cues is automatically inserted into the Main Object tab. If you insert a text cue into your script, the created cue will have the main object set up as embedded text, which refers to the custom text that you enter into MediaShout. If you create a graphic or video cue and then decide to add text at a later point, you can do that by going to the Main Object tab and adding one of the main object types. Once a text element has been created in the Main Object tab, you can move or resize the text box on the screen to whatever size or position you desire by dragging the handles on the text box border and by dragging the text box itself. You can enter or select text in the preview window and use the tools provided to format the text. You can change the font, font size, text color, and the bold, italic, and underline settings. We've also created a convenient tool that allows you to easily set both the vertical and horizontal text alignment at once. Simply click on the tool and select the position that you want your text to align. Immediately below the standard text formatting tools is a drop-down menu where you can select how you would like your text to transition from page to page. You can click the right end of the tool to choose a transition from a list, or you can customize the in and out transitions independently. As you format your text, if you want all of the pages in your text object to use the settings you have just applied to the current page, simply click the Apply to Queue button, and all other pages will be updated with those formatting changes. Because graphic and video files do not flow from page to page, you will insert and format them on the Other Objects tab. If the graphic or video file has already been inserted as part of creating the queue, you will find it in the object list at the lower left corner of the queue editor. Above that, you will find the page list, which indicates the objects that are used on each page. If the media file that you would like to use hasn't been inserted yet, or if you would like to add an additional object to the page, you can click the New Object button at the top of the tab and select the type of object you'd like to add. As soon as you select the desired object type, MediaShout provides the appropriate method for browsing and inserting that content. The Objects list is where you can click on an object to select it. Then you can move or change its size on the screen, control its visibility, insert it onto all pages of a queue, move it up or down to display it in front of or behind other objects, or delete it. Please note, though, that you cannot remove the last object in a queue. Once you've selected the media object that you want to format, you can adjust the settings on the top right side of the Queue Editor tab. The most common thing that you will adjust with media files is the size and position at which they display on the screen. And we've provided some simple controls for the most common settings. The drop-down menu offers two full-screen options along with a setting for custom sizes. You'll notice that if you drag any of the object handles or the object itself, custom will automatically be selected in the list, so you don't normally need to select that option. The other two options will display the file in a preset manner. Full scale will scale the object up or down so that the entire file is visible. This may cause the object to not fill the screen if the width to height ratio or aspect ratio of the file is not the same as your main display. However, it will always display the entire graphic or video, and it will always maintain the correct aspect ratio. Because of this, the full scale setting is best for graphics and video that contain recognizable objects or people. The full stretch option will always fill the entire screen. If the aspect ratio of your file is different than your main display, the file will be stretched to fill the screen. While this is generally acceptable for abstract graphics, videos, and most images that have a horizontal or landscape aspect ratio, vertical images will be severely stretched and not display correctly. The most basic place to apply a transition is on the General tab. This transition is applied to all queue content that is present as the queue begins. The queue that is being replaced will have the reverse of this transition applied, so you'll have an equal and opposite transition. In addition to the global transition that is applied to the entire queue entrance, individual objects can also be assigned their own transitions. The pages of text on the main object tab can each be assigned both in and out transitions, and each object on the other objects tab can also be assigned transitions. This provides an extraordinary level of creative possibilities.